Welcome back to Let's Play Little Buses. Well, that confirms it. It did record the audio, so we're good.
My head was still killing me. Even as I sleep and dream, the voices were tightening. Darkness, my old friends. God damn it. How do I click off of it? It's clearly on the screen. How does it do that? Surprised I haven't done this till now. Well, it's not like I can read the kanji category. I know this kanji category is like darkness, but I guess they're combining kanji characters there. If you ever played Yu-Gi-Oh or, you know, anything like that, you know, you got that card, Yami. That's basically darkness. I mean, it's kind of obvious. You look at the card, it's like, yes. It's like dark and like dark purple and boost fiend dark monsters and stuff like that, you know. Dark type monsters. So it's darkness, basically. There's only darkness. Darkness surrounds me. No, that's wrong. It isn't even darkness. Without the existence of light, how could there be darkness? Without the existence of something separate, how is water wet? Because water is not wet unless it comes into contact with something. Where I am now is nothingness. We have fallen victim to the never-ending story. The nothing has consumed Riki. I see nothing at all. That is a certain kind of salvation. I still have the headache, but here at this moment, the headache is the only proof of my existence. I am starting to regain my thoughts, and I seem to be remembering how to command my body again. I try to move my fingers, and they move. My fingertips scratch the hard concrete. My head still feels heavy. I'm regaining all my feelings, and it makes my headache harder. Nay, did he actually hit his head? If he fell on concrete, that's not gonna be good. That's probably why he's got the headache. So I'm awake now. And the first thing he sees is Railoff or whatever that guy's name is from Skyrim. Ah, he finally wakes like, no! As soon as I realized that, I felt something soft underneath me. If I remember correctly, I was on the rooftop and fell down to the concrete ground. I must have put something over when I went down. That thing is a little stiff and touching my lower back. What's that? What are you doing over there, birds? He's just scuttling around on the bottom of the cage. So he's doing some kind of Michael Jackson walk or something. That is a person, because it's warm, and my head is on a softer part of their body. You're on their lap? I open my eyes. At first, all I see is my shadow on the concrete ground under me. Then I move my sight to the right. My eyes meet Komari Sans. She's bearing my entire weight. I'm sorry. I hastily roll to the side. You know, this is my chronic disease. She quickly stood up and peered intently into my face. Well, I'm okay, I guess. You know, I don't really know a lot about narcolepsy, but, you know, anyone who's more, you know, familiar with that, it's like, how accurate are they portraying narcolepsy with Riki here? Or is it not as accurate? I don't know, it's kind of a random thing to give the protagonist, isn't it? Like, okay, let's give the protagonist narcolepsy. So, you know, at points in the plot, we can have that come into play where he passes out to, you know, have, like, a dramatic scene of sorts. Yeah. Does this make me think of Katawa Shoujo? It's like, would that count? If, you know, if Riki was in the same world as that game, would he be able to attend that school because of his narcolepsy? Because, I don't know, It's like the protagonist went there because he had, like, a heart condition. You got all those students there, you know, they got, like, missing limbs, other health stuff and all conditions. I mean, would narcolepsy count enough for that school? She gave me a sigh of relief. Because, you know, if you have something like that where you will just kind of pass out on the spot at, you know, random points and there's nothing you can do about it, you'd need some kind of, you know, you'd have to have someone who's got your back on that. I'm sorry I got you in trouble. That was making me think of South Park, you know, Cartman in that one episode with the Tourette's. And he sees it as something awesome to have when it's not. He's probably thinking the same about narcolepsy. He's like, no way! You're telling me you can fall asleep in class and get away with it? Kick ass, this sounds awesome! It's like, it's not awesome, Cartman, it sucks. Right, you didn't actually have to do anything. I always wake up after a while. That's what the disease is like. I suddenly fall asleep and that's it. I mean, is that really it? Is that all there is to it? Oh, she's not even aware of it? She said that maybe with such worrying in her eyes. She looks about to cry. To be more precise, she's already half crying. No worries, I'm definitely okay. Oh, it surprises me, you know. When he woke up, and you know the description, he was clearly, probably like, on her lap or something like that, right? That kind of visual, you'd expect it to like, suddenly CG, but no, there's no CG. It's like, however, her getting dressed, ass in the air, nude in one case, apparently. Yeah, that's a CG. It's like, this moment where, you know, Riki just wakes up on her lap, no CG. No CG at all. I don't want to see you making that face. I smiled to her. You know what I think it is? Riki's face is so bland and generic they don't want to show his face whenever possible. I don't think it's that. It just seems in general in visual novels, the protagonist, you know, we never really see the protagonist's face all that much. It's always obscured. By the way, are you okay, Komari-san? I mean, I pushed you over and buried you under me. Wait, what? What, did he fall onto her? Is it what I thought? I thought he was just resting on her lap. Did he straight up fall on her like... Oh man, it's a real random reference. I don't know if it applies to all the jackpots in the Tekken series, but there's definitely some versions of the jackpot where he does this press where he just like drops front onto his opponent and he's like gets back up. Just picture it like that. She finally recalled how we were stuck to each other. This sounds wrong. Well, that's... It didn't really bother me now, seeing how she was feeling embarrassed enough for the both of us. I mean, how would... I mean, if that were a CG... It's like, I thought he was just like resting on her lap or something like that, but if he just straight up fell on her, how would that look for a CG? I can't even picture that. You just have Riki's face just completely obscured and just see Hikamaru looking down at him like, ah. Are you sure it was 1 hour? Now I noticed that I was sweating where our bodies had been connected. I put my hand on my chest and relived that soft feeling that greeted me. What? Her boobs are bigger than I would have imagined.
Why? You thought she was...
I mean, what? Forget it. Mount, skip the beat as I recalled it. And I guess she's not flat-chested. Maybe you expected that, I don't know. Maybe you expected it to be like a board. No, I wasn't going to do anything. Yeah, no, there was nothing you could do in that situation. Seemed like she was trying hard to calm herself down. On the other hand, I was trying to sort out what had transpired. Slept for an hour, didn't I? That's long. Actually, an hour isn't that long for it. Worst comes to worst, I would sleep for 6 or 7 hours. Can you imagine them stuck on the roof for that long? Class has already begun. Sorry I've made trouble for you. I didn't think that was something to get so troubled over. Here's an idea, I'm going to the infirmary now, so you tell the class you helped take me there. Glad about what? Yeah, I told you so. I'm okay because I'm no longer dreaming. I think you should keep it for now. Let me see it tomorrow. Imagine he just passes out the second time as well. It's like, clearly there's something about that book that makes you fall asleep, and it's not even reading it, it's just simply being in his presence that makes you fall asleep. It felt like I shouldn't take that book away from her hands. It felt like, how should I say it, something sacred. I think it's too much. I split up with Komari-san at the stairs as we agreed. You don't have to, I can take care of it. She headed for the classroom, waving her hand. One thought occurred to me, occupied me as I walked down the hall. Komari-san's older brother. What he was going to be like, Komari-san's breasts. That's the one thing that occurs to him. Does he really exist? Or rather, did he? Best case scenario would be that he does and is still living somewhere. Seems a lot unlikely, though, doesn't it? Next best would be that he, in the first place, never even existed. Well, that would just be weird. I didn't want to think about the other possibilities. Anyway, I know little or nothing about him at the moment. Well, I couldn't get anywhere even if I kept thinking about it. My speculation didn't change anything. Not the first time Key has done a story like this, isn't it? After a 30-minute stay in the infirmary, I heard the chime marking the end of fifth period. I left for my classroom.
Oh, Riki!
Soon as I entered the classroom, Mouseheader called me.
Wow.
Yeah, I am. Though if anyone who could easily carry Riki anywhere, it would be Masato. He'd probably just bung him over one shoulder. Yeah, I wish it were up to me. Sounded good, but I could not mask his kindness. So during a class. I got a text. From who? Try not to draw attention, I covertly open it. Sundae, Kyousuke, Natsume, subject, no subject. Message, I want to do something for Komari to thank her for the party. If you agree with my idea, contact me before school's out. Wow. This was an unusually square proposition for me. The party was really fun, and she, as the host, had done a lot of things for us. I totally seconded the motion, even though Now, the previous part, I skipped through that scene because they did not deserve a party after their horrible performance in that baseball match. Look how undetailed these characters are here in the class. It's like, they're just background characters. We don't need to, you know, just put in kind of bare minimum design here. We've got a lot of these to, you know, draw in here, so they're our main characters. Just make them look so that they look like they're different people and not just copy and paste clones. I sent him back an okay. And next time, received null text. Then the girl's getting out to see me, subject, reply, no subject. Message. Chances are good that Komari will find out if we talk in our classroom, therefore let's meet up in the hallway near the classroom. FYI, no one disagreed. Seems to want to keep quiet about it, better surprise her later. But what on earth is he going to do? Did he even do anything for Komari in the previous round for that? I can't remember. Recess. I have to go see Kyousuke. He wasn't in the hallway yet. Well, I'm not sure what the other options are in Komari's route at this point, so I'm going to check the walkthrough, but it's probably this choice doesn't matter as much. But I'm going to check it. Yeah, as of what, this choice doesn't seem to matter, so let's just wait, I guess. Okay, I'll wait. Still no sign of him. I wonder, is he with the other members? No, I doubt it, since they are in all out. They are all in the classroom.
So,
oh no. Swah! Ah! Finger ran across my back as the voice called my name.
Yeah.
Would that count as harassment? Can you please stop surprising me every time you see me?
それが私のアイデンティティだ.
Your identity is to be, you know, a walking sexual harassment. What a troublesome identity.
まあ、それはどうでもいい. リキ君は京介氏を待っているのか?
Yeah, you too.
いや、私も聴衆に回ることにしている.
Is it protection money? Money for what?
コマリ君は甘いものが大好きだ.
I get it. This plan must be to treat her to something sweet.
ついて、一人頭200円ほど徴収させてもらう.
That's not really a lot of money. Okay, that's no problem at all.
うん.
I handed over 200 yen coins and she put them in an envelope. Judging from the sound, she'd already collected from the rest of the members.
では、あとは君が現地に連れて行くだけだね.
Eh? Me?
最近、コマリ君と一番仲がいいのは君かリン君なの. リン君にそのことを伝えると、顔を真っ赤にして逃げてしまったので、君しかいない. 買い物とか適当に理由をつけて連れ出してくれ.
Ah. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is exclusive to Komari's route, isn't it? This didn't happen in the previous route. I mean, you can tell we're on Komari's route now, because there's no longer the calendar up here. Whenever the calendar or whatever, you know, disappears in a key visual novel, you know you're officially on a character route. Rin isn't good at doing something like that.
まあ、そういうわけで任せたい.
Have we seen that expression on her face before?
コマリ君の喜ぶ顔が見られんというのも残念な話だ.
Hey, aren't you going?
残念ながらだ. というか、現地に行くのは君と京介氏の二人だ. それとも、二人きりの方が良かったか?
Hey, no, not at all.
やっちゃってもいいぞ.
Phrasing? I won't!
まあ、合いびきならベッドを約束を取り付けるといい。とりあえず地図を渡しておこう。土地勘があれば迷うことはないと思うが、一応な。余裕があったら甘いものを頬張るコマリ君の画像でも私に送信しておいてくれ。
Alright. Okay, so what I have to do is take her out after school. No, this is not a date or anything, but it makes me kind of nervous to ask a girl out. Feels like you've been set up for a date here. I got quite a sign of school. I end up taking the why don't we go shopping together option.
お買い物?
I just can't picture a scenario where, you know, a guy asks a friend of his that is a girl, asks, you know, we're gonna go shopping. Hell, even if they were together, I can't imagine it, Tyler. It'd be the other way around. I don't know, it's that stereotype, isn't it? I mean, I've experienced that stereotype. I mean, not all girls, not all women are like that, you know, it's just like shopping for freaking ever. I mean, some guys are like that as well, I'd imagine. But it definitely seems more like, you know, stereotypical kind of scenario where, like, you get a guy and he's just, like, carrying his girlfriend's bags around as he's going on a shopping spree and he's just like... You know? Not, doesn't apply to everyone, of course. What baseball practice? Are they continuing even after that? Did I read that? Yeah, I need to go to a store near the station. No practice today because Kyousuke is busy. Plus, we don't have a match anytime soon. It really does feel like when they made Little Buses, it can't have been that long after, you know, Clannad, basically. So they must have been like, okay, for the common route, let's do the baseball route from Clannad. But with the characters in this new novel, Little Busters. But unlike in Clannad, we're going to have it so the team absolutely sucks and loses over and over, over and over, and eventually maybe get a win at some point. But until then, they suck. Thank you. I succeeded in asking her more smoothly than I expected. Because it's thanks to her affable personality. We left the school together and headed for the cafe. I wonder how big that bridge actually is. It's like, this is quite wide, you know, we don't we've got some buildings in the background to kind of give you a general idea of scale, I guess. It's not like a super long bridge, you know, but it is pretty long, but not super long. Sure has. You're walking abreast along a road next to the river. Abreast. You still got it on the mind, subliminally. It was almost summer and the grasses on the bank were green and lustrous. Days like today are the best for walking. Komari-san was speaking in a quiet, nostalgic voice, looking at a bunch of white flowers on the bank. Girls like doing stuff like that, huh? I did that too. I used them as bookmarks when I found them. She dropped her shoulders in disappointment, recalling it. I have. Kyousuke was always way better than me at finding something like that, though. He once found one for each member. How did he ever do that? No one but him knows. Maybe he has some superpower. You know, like in video games, you hold down a button and it like highlights specific objects you're supposed to find. He just does that. He like taps, puts on some glasses, taps the side of it, something like that. It's like beep beep over here. There's a four-leaf clover. Right. Well, you'll see soon.
じゃあ楽しみにしておくよ。
They go into town and Kyousuke set him up with a drug dealer. He's like, Kyousuke, what the hell? I thought we knew you, Kyousuke. We didn't realize you were into this shit. The two of us sampled the head shatting. You know, I'm just now, for whatever reason, picturing Komari and Riki ending up like, the intro of Grand Theft Auto Vice City, where that drug deal at the start goes wrong. The question is Riki the protagonist or the Rosenberg guy? Is Komari worthy of being the protagonist? I can't picture his either one. I can't picture either of them. Just picture it. It's just weird. Think of the weirdest stuff sometimes, man. Finally, we reached the broad streets, not sheets, in front of the station. Well, I checked out the map.
そうだ。この辺りにすごいお店があるんだよ。
Oh yeah?
喫茶店なんだけど、そこに普通の大きさなのにお値段3倍のパフェがあるんだよ。
Sounds great. I'm impressed that she knows about the cafe already. How are you impressed that she knows that?She's into sweets, man. She knows this stuff.
雑誌とかにも載ってたから、いつもすごい混んでるんだけどね。私も行ったことあるんだけど、ものすごい美味しいみたいなんだよ。
I see. Terrible price Sundae. I wonder whether that isn't the goal of this little trip. Have you ever had it, Komari-san?
No.さすがに高くて無理だよ。
But if everyone chips in 200 yen...
一回くらいは食べてみたいんだけどね。
Now, is this me, you know, when she was looking to the side a bit, it made it look like these were attached to her hair. If so, that would be the most fitting present for Komari-san.Well, we are here.
さっき言ってたのがあのお店だよ。
She points at a cafe. Despite it being a weekday, there were already several people lining up in front of the cafe. That made me realize just how popular the cafe was.
行きたいな。
She was staring at the cafe with a wishful look. Well, Kyousuke is supposed to be in there ahead of us. We walked to the front door of the cafe.
ようこそお客様。
We don't get to see the interior of the cafe because, you know, drawing it would seem a bit pointless considering it's probably only gonna appear for like one route. Seems a bit excessive. For some reason, Kyousuke was standing in front of the line.
Kyousuke-san?
ああ、Kyousuke-san だ。ま、細かいことは抜きだ。入った入った。
He pushed us into the cafe. Never mind, we do see the interior. Forget I said anything. He courteously led us to our seats. So much for them saying it's crowded, though. I mean, it's empty. Nice little cozy design, though. Looks like he's playing the part of a waiter.
心配するな。このために予約しておいた席だ。
Komari-san still couldn't grasp the situation. This is our way of thanking you for the party you threw for us. Except we only do it for your ride, nobody else's. I guess you could say maybe it's implied to happen regardless. I don't know.
俺たちみんなからの感謝を込めた贈り物ってやつさ。
She was shaking her head vigorously, all awkward.
何?贈り物にはお礼を。お礼にはまた贈り物を。お前の言ってたことさ。
He's right, you don't have to be that modest.
そういうことさ。マスター。
He snapped his fingers.
例のもの。
Immediately, a shop assistant came up with a cup of sundae.CG! Always nice to get a new CG, isn't it? What's in front of her eyes was nothing else but the triple prize Royal Princess Sundae. You know what this means? This means I've got a, you know, let's do that again. It's like, I've got to screenshot this right here. At some point. I know. Doesn't even need to have, like, you know, with or without text, you know? Gotta take a screenshot of it because I want this to be the thumbnail. And you just know, we're 30 minutes in. It's not going to be the default thumbnail at all. Maybe this will be the default thumbnail because, you know, she's like, oh my god! Her eyes were sparkling just looking at it. They were proof that the project was a perfect success. How much did it cost? What's on more than a tiny fine grain sugar that's known for its melt-in-the-mouth properties associated with the Japanese Shikoku region that's heavily used to prepare Japanese confections? But yes, the Shikoku region. Everyone knows where that is. I don't. It's like, you could have the map of Japan and be like, point where you think that region is. I'd be like, ah. Dunno. I mean, I think I might have a little trouble just pointing out where Tokyo would be and be like, okay, that's somewhere between south and the middle. I know Hokkaido, I think, is like the bit up north. And that's about it. I don't know anything else. Now, I find it interesting about Japan is that if you think about Japan, you just think, you know, like Britain, for example, it's an island, basically. But it's not just one island, there's like, isn't there like at least two? Like, they're kind of like broken up a bit. I think. I'm pretty sure it is like that, right? Because I've heard, like, it's like, oh yeah, on the main island or whatever, Japan or whatever. I don't know, I can't remember. I'm pretty sure it's like not just one whole bit of land that's connected perfectly together. I guess it's probably comparable, well, sort of, maybe. Do you know, like, how Britain and Ireland are separated by a bit of sea? But, you know, that the general area we can call, like, the British Isles and stuff. Whatever. Doesn't matter. To explain all the ingredients from bottom to
top. What? If you have a lot of skill, you can put this kind of cafe in your hands. It's a very easy thing.
That ends up being Kyosuke's guy, like, screw being a salaryman or whatever. Like, I am going to become the owner of this cafe. That is my life's goal. Can you imagine how heartbreaking it would be if that fell on the floor? Oh, man. I'll never get bored watching her. Well, but you just eat it. Sure. He tapped me on the shoulder. Where are you going? They're clearly, you know, it's a two-for-one deal here, you know? It makes Komari happy, and they're also like, nudge, nudge, Riki. We see that you and Komari have been spending some time together. Why don't you date her?
Nani? Sono egao dake de jubun sa.
Only Kyousuke can look good saying something so utterly ostentatious. With a thumbs up, he disappeared into the kitchen. Kyousuke approved. How come he went in there? Where did he go again? Disappeared into the kitchen, yeah. Why is he in the kitchen? Oh, please don't hold back. Then she eats like an absolute animal. And he's like, holy crap. She scooped up a little bit of cream covered with sauce. And she carried it into her mouth. Her face burst into a blooming smile, exuding an aura of happiness around her like a ripple. Eh, no, I'm fine. Eat up, it's all yours. Seems like I have no choice but to comply. Okay, just one bite though. She scooped up some cream and sauce and held the spoon out to me. What? Okay, people must be thinking we are a completely lovey-dovey couple. I feel that's probably the point. I opened my mouth and took the spoonful.
And see?
So smooth. Just as she said, it really is tasty. Yet again, she stretched her arm out to feed me. Riki, do you have like, would it be, I mean, if you were in this situation, wouldn't you feel at least a tad bit embarrassed? I mean, this place looks empty, but it's not supposed to be. That's awesome as well. After that, she ate the cup completely clean by herself. Even on the way back, she was radiating happiness.
So, so much for being so happy.
So, you got the 200 yen you paid for the
cup. Ah, so that's what it
is. How much would that be? We can't even look at that anymore, unfortunately. Let's see. Obviously, Komari didn't chip in because this was all for Komari, so. Let's just see. Riki, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seven, eight, nine. So nine, right? Four? Five, six, seven, eight, nine. Yeah, nine. I'm bad with math, so, you know, I'll do the math in editing so that to see how much all that added up to. What's wrong, Rin? She's still not good at being honest. By the way, Kyousuke, what did you, do after she and I left the cafe? Wait, is that what happened? It's like, okay, in exchange for this, I'll do all the dishes for, like, the day. Eh?
あの店で予約なんてやってなくてな。無理って席取っといてもらったんだ。
He said something absurd as if it were nothing.
ま、しなくていいとは言われたが、一度言った手前、やらないとまずいだろ。
That's our leader. Once he decides to do something, he does it thoroughly. When I got to the roof, Komari-san wasn't yet there. I sat down on one of the steps leading up to the water tank and poked a straw into a juice carton. It's a good place for thinking.
far away from the bustle of school life. All I heard now was the wind blowing. I was surrounded by silence. And there's this one person up here, it's really quiet. Oh, Komari-san comes up here soon. So I thought that. I heard somebody pry open the window.
Oh, Mikiko! Jou wa hayai ne!
She trotted up to me with a plastic bag in both hands. It's inside the bags.
Kino, okashi taberarenakatta kara.
And I should have stopped it there, then it could have been like, you know, what she have in the bag? Is it a severed head? No. That'd be a hell of a dark twist. It's like, yeah, Komari, she's just like, I want to introduce you today. I found my old brother. It's just severed head. It's like, Jesus Christ, what the hell is the story going to places that it should never go to? Yeah, that'd be attractive. Like, how to get out of here quickly? We're on a roof. Nobody knows we're here. I'm so screwed. I definitely can't eat that much. Today as well, our lunch was pancakes packed with jelly. Let me ask something. She looked at me munching her pancake. You make pancakes for lunch every morning? That will be the cliffhanger. Does she make pancakes every morning? Yeah, thrilling cliffhanger right there. But we're up to 42 minutes here, and like I said, I don't want to do long recordings. I'll do 3 recordings, why not? Get 3 parts here, but you know, do it separate each time just to make sure that the audio is actually recording properly. That's how I'm going to do it from now on. So it's going to be slightly a bit more of a pain in the ass, because I can't just have one long continuous recording. But whatever. See you next time, viewers. See you next time.